Well, out in a new spot this morning. It's Thursday. I don't know what day it is, date-wise, but it's Thursday. And I've been wanting to get out to this spot for a while. And the dang rain, Missouri got some last night, but it all stayed right at Jeff City, I-70 and north. So Mr. Rick Jitsu and Mackie and all you guys up that way, you ought to be having a real good season. We really, really needed it here. And they said we have a chance for tonight and tomorrow morning, so maybe. I'm still a-hoping. But, oh dang, there's one down there I ain't even seen yet. But just come to this ash tree, and usually there's some water oaks and white oaks in here. I pick them around, and some hackberries, but just an ash tree. But here's a group of five, and then I just spotted a fresh poking up behind me. But, oh boy, it's nice to get here. It's a hog farmer's property, and you about gotta go through his house to get back here, so it's kind of a protected little spot. These are some nice ones too now. Oh, some nice ones. So hopefully I'll have a pretty good picking here today, but I sure wish it was around more than just the ash trees. And man, I mean, it's not too bad right here, but well, you can see some right there. That's all wild rose bushes, and then it's just full of gooseberries. Every time I come in here, I come out of here with my legs just tore up, man, even with good jeans on. And I didn't know, oh, there's another one, and it's been knocked over. Awesome, that makes seven around this one tree. Well, I hope that's a good sign to come in here now. I'm going to have to scour around here real good. See if I find any more. I just love morels, man. And I so bad need to be hitting some of my good creek spots. That creek rolled like mad up over the banks, but... And who's ever beat me in at that one spot? The first, well, it was actually the second spot I went to, but went there by myself without Terry. And, should have went back to the other spot too, but I got all year I can arrowhead hunt. Only got a short period in these 80 degree days, and if it gets windy, it dries these mushrooms out. And then a storm can come through and just beat them up. And they'd be gone. Well, guess that's all that's here. Not bad for the first find. I'll take it. And that works probably even better as a phone case than the one I had, but it's tight fitting in there. And it's waterproof, but it's normally for my phone. Out during adventures, especially in the creek, I'll just have to get me another one. Heck, that case I had was $15, and them thing are five. I mean... I'll do the math. Well, going that big ass tree up there, I missed. Hopefully some more. Loving it, loving it, loving it. Thanks for watching these guys. I really appreciate it. Shrooms or something. I'm like a kid in a candy store with $1 million in my pocket and ain't nobody in my damn way to spend it. I'm just like a little kid again. Awesome. And these gooseberries are thick. Thick and scratchy. There's a couple been up for a few days. They'll still eat though. Not all that moldy stuff off. Alright. Need some more big batches. Just picked that one right there. But dang, it's so thick in here. Friggin' stepping on them. Look at that. Stepped all over that one. Spored around for next year. Man, these gooseberries are stacked. Can't be stepping on anymore. That's not good. Heck no. Well, just moving along here through from ash tree to ash tree. Little common to little commons. That's good. Well, if we'd rain, it'd cool off the big white too. Look, I got a hole in the side there. I need to sew that up. Oh, look, it was hiding right next to it. Just right next to it. Didn't even see him. That is live action, huh? Little boogers are good for hiding. Like Jason said, they'll hide everywhere. Well, can't pick them and put them in the sack at the same time. And hopefully it looks like it's going to be a better day. Well, not every ash tree's got them, but about every other one. Here's even got his little head burnt up a little bit, but that'll trim right off. At least them kind of usually got pretty good stems on them. If you get it all pinched off, I make sure I don't leave that in the woods today. But that's pretty easy to see. Well, at least I'm out of picking them today. That's all I ask for, is to have more to eat. Wish I was picking them like normal, though. Usually by now, heck, this many days, when did I start? I think last Thursday, a week ago, with them blacks. And then Saturday had that good batch of blacks and a few whites and grays and a couple batches here and after there. Usually by now, I'd have 400 for sure first week. Sad. But I sure get happy every time I see that. Yep, nice little common. 3-incher. Alright. Actually, about right at 3 inches. But I can definitely tell it's either being a low year or a slow year for our locale. Because this spot, I usually pick them around every single ash tree in here, and then there'll be some around water oaks and white oaks and some real good elms, and I ain't found any around the elm yet. And back, I can't remember where you're at, hon, but I just read that message you left that come through on my Gmail. Said you picked 52. All right, hon. And you was getting some rain. Yeah, look at there. Right in front of me. That's why I stand around and spin around a bunch. And if that's not a gray, I'll kiss that mushroom. I still may kiss it. But that's a gray. That's a common. Tell by the colors. So. And yes, flint ball, I don't want that dirt in there. You gotta give them a little blow once in a while. Besides, that help blows off some spores. Well, them spores, I just saw fly. Well, two more to the bag is better than looking sad, that's for sure. And having to watch for the ticks and pick them off once in a while, too. Or burn them. See, look right there, there's a little baby tick. But I usually keep the lighter handy, and boom, that little sucker is fried. Fried tickage. Well, don't see no more or any more shrooms. Meant to buy some permadone at Walmart. That stuff actually keeps the ticks off. Only stuff I've ever found that really works good. Permadone, it says for clothing treatment only, lasts up to 2 weeks through 2 washings. You turkey hunters, I'd be investing in that, because this year's going to be awful on the ticks, just because we had no winter. And I'm already getting little bitty like yearlings on me, like that one I just burnt off. Well, enough yakking, back to picking. Just coming along to the Ozark Hills, coming along to the Ozark Hills. And look what spills out from the ground. Oh, pretty flowers are trapped by. and I hit a good spot right here. Yep, look at that nice baby. One hiding over here. One hiding up there. One hiding there. Two way up there. Some really good ones. Right here. Growed up big. Oops. Plucked the dirt from them. Little one over here. He's been up a little while. Three. Four. Oops. Oh, pinch off her. Oh. Oh, and then over here. Well, I like it when I come find them in them little batches like that around one tree. It's nice. Some of them's pretty fresh. Well, alright. Good score right here. Hopefully it keeps coring on. Just ash trees. I don't get it why they ain't around some other trees. But look at this big dude I just found here. Oh man. We want as much stem of him as we can get. Oops. He's a big fatty now. Man, we got a little one over here. Oh, where was it? There was a spot I may be standing on it. Or someone had picked one here. Must have been a few days back or something. I know his boy comes in here and he just picks enough for a small mess. They don't like to eat too many. I don't know why. I could eat the things forever. I wish I could eat them year round. Which, if I find a bunch, I'd dry them out just by letting them naturally dry out. And I take them to a buddy's that's got one of them zip vacs. And the big ones I'll cut in half. And the little ones I leave whole. And zip vac them up. And if you get all the air out of them, keep them from getting freezer burnt. Dang bugs crawling on me. They last quite a while. That one there is awesome to find. I got some old toadstools growing out. Down there. We don't eat them kind. Them's not good eating. See, that one there didn't have a single one around it. And so there's a couple others back there. And I get over here and boom. And I just found that little one on the other side of the tree. But they just keep getting bigger and better as it come down the one farther down the hill. And look, there's even a couple. Look how big this dude here is, man. Oh, wow. Man, I'm having such a hard time using that right hand. Wow, that dude was juicy, juicy. These little, here's another little bee common. I didn't even see till I bent down. A couple little commons, and they're fresh. And these great big ones. Woohoo! Man, it is being a good pick today. Glad I saved this spot. Why are these some of these little ash trees? Are giving me a nice score. There's a real nice one. Mold fingers work. God, juice just come out of that baby, man. Boy, now that means I get to eat some tonight. I can eat that bowl in the fridge that I got waiting that I didn't eat last night. I better take a break on them one night. Look at that sack today, would you? baby's looking. That's the best. This is the best I've had so far. Sweet. I've got a bunch of trees cut down at this end. Oop, there's a little one. I just passed up. Back there. I didn't see. This one here caught my eye. And then that one there caught my eye. Drove it up in here around all the falling over tree. I'm glad they ain't none way off in there, because I'd have to get an axe out to get to them. I mean, whoo, that's thick. I like dirt. I pulled up. Wow, look at that big curled over baby, huh? Yeah, I've been hearing turkeys all around me this morning. Well, I just seen another one right back there. Where's that little common I just seen? I lost. Okay, it's up there. Oh, gosh. Dang. Boy, getting up and down for mushrooms sure ain't easy. There's them two. There's my camera case. Ow. I just felt a stick poke me in the back of the leg, too, right through the pants. Oh. No more, no more, no more, no more, no more, no more. Nope, here's another one right here, another little one. Live action. Ooh, yeah, baby. Wow, look at that big clump of dirt I brought up with that. I can't pinch him. All right. Ow. My right arm, holy cow. Oh yeah, one right in front of my freaking arch of my stick in the ground. Oh man, how about that? Didn't even see it there. Awesome. Just awesome. Well, I know who's going to be eating mushrooms for a couple nights now. Oh, everybody pray for me to get some rain. So it brings on the great biggins, the great big whites, and all the trees that haven't produced will produce. Come on, give me a big prey. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. They are just... Man, I'm hitting some good trees down at this edge of the hill. Some good batches of them, man. But boy, are they hard to get to. And pulling them up don't hurt them, but leaving some stem sure helps. But using that net sack to drop spores while you're out picking them is what makes a difference. Don't see any more nestled up in there. That cobweb of a mess anywhere. I say, you always gotta look around real good. And that's a nice score too. Getting closer to the edge of this hill, and then I go down on this bottom. Hoping the bottom, it don't have as many good trees, but it's got some. Won't admit, treats me just as good up there as it did, or down there as it did up here. Killer. Just killer, man. I better look around over here some, too. And them biggins are fresh now. And it's been too warm the last couple nights, but boy, they're coming up. If it would rain and cool off like it did last year I didn't even pick any till April 3rd or the 5th. On my notes, I can't remember exactly this morning, but, so I'm still a week or days away from when I first picked them last year. And last year, the two end weeks of March, it was 60 at night and 80 degrees. And then it finally rained and cooled off, and look, here's a little one I missed down here. Stand around and look for a while. That and talking sure don't help. Used to not filming shrooms. It's probably taking twice as long. as it normally does, come through here and pick them, but I don't care. How many was that here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mushrooms were on one tree. Ow, my boot. Awesome. Back to hoping to find some more. Over there's where I went in and then took off down that way down the hill and come back, and I know there's a few ash trees through this other side scattered out, and I usually a lot of times don't go through it, but my bag's pretty good size there, but still fuller than what I'd like it to be. And this is kind of a drive for the house, so I'm thinking I'm gonna use up every bit of time I got. But man, I just stepped out here by the road and they just come through here while I go in their tractor. And you can tell they ain't been paying attention down here. Right there's a dried up one, which is too good, but look at them all. Here's one, two, three. Oh, come on. Yeah, that's a nice one. How could you go by and not see these? There's four. And there's five. Here's six and seven. And then look, there's even three back here. There's a dried up one there, and there's one down in there, and another one over there. There may even be another one hiding over there I don't see yet. What was that on this side? That was seven. Oh wow, there's a half free morel I didn't even see before. Wow. Oops, zoom out. Oh, Michael. I'll have to get a picture of that one before I take it. Awesome. Just friggin' awesome. Any more hiding on this side? Nope. Well, I'm gonna have to get out and stroll through these woods, I guess. Okay, besides that half free, that was 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 mushrooms around one tree. I love it when that happens. And look, some of them babies is fresh. Man, if it would just rain. Oh my gosh, if it would rain, it would be on. So awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I have to get a plastic sack out for long. The top of that bag's getting holes in it from brush. Well, finally some mushrooms around some elm trees. And look at this. I mean, I am right off the highway. And I found this spot one time. I was driving real slow. And I was actually in a pickup truck. And right here somewhere, there was two mushrooms that was, I ain't kidding you, they was over 12 inches tall. I got a cell pic of it, I think, on my older phone. But I just found nine, I think, here. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that's a big one too. 7, 8, 9. Well, I better get off here and get these picked before I get caught by someone driving by, and see if this hillside's got some more. It usually does. Finally, some by some elm trees. And look at this, I am right by the highway, and I found this spot one year, but there was two of them growing like right in here somewhere, about 12 inches, 14 inches tall, and you could see them from the road. But I just picked one. There's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and that's a big one, 8, 9, right here. But I better get these picked and get this up this hill a little ways, because I'm pure visible. Well, here we are in another undisclosed location. And, I mean, right off the side of the road again. And, there's two. There's one. But these are little. Oh, there's even a little dried up head next to it. Set them all right there. There's one. There's four. Over here's five, six, and seven. I've been up a little while too. But they're still soaking the water and eat good. And over here, by this ash tree, is a nice size one. Look at that, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, not many ash trees through here, but a few. So, maybe I'll get a good little stash of them in here, too. See another little ash tree right there, but I don't see nothing from here, but I'll have to get closer to get my sack out. Sacked him up. I am loving today, man. Loving today, yeah, baby. Live action. I'm in camouflage. You don't see me. I'm in camouflage. I love it when you can see them big ones from a far distance. I mean, I seen that one from plum over there. About had to run over here. That nice biggin'. Yeah, baby. That damn cedar out of it. That won't taste no good. Leave that for spores. For bringing back some more. Sack's getting a lot of holes in it. It's a repair to find me a new one. Uh-oh, that's not good. Bottom hole, too. Kind of side hole. Well, probably getting dizzy with me spinning the camera all around. Sorry. Getting excited. That's that big-ass tree way up there. I just picked somewhere. Look at all the traffic going by. And then there wasn't one around this ash tree. But I know I'm glad I got good eyes. Because look right in between that branch that's falling down. I don't know if you can see it that far from here or not by the camera. I know I can sure see it. I like them ones that stick up now. But just one. Just one here. 82 mushrooms today. Brooksy's a happy camper. Ugh. And some of them's nice too. Oh, back row. Oh, biggins. Oh, biggins. Nice, fresh. Tasty Morels, yes! I'm a happy camper. Yummy, yummy.
Suicide. fail. We fight a losing war on a foreign shore to find his country and to want him back. The bullets took his best friends in Saigon. Our Lord took his wife, his kids, no regrets. Any time I don't remember, and a war he can't forget. He cried, forgive me for what I'd done there, 'cause I never meant the things I did. And give me something to believe in, that there's a Lord above. And give me something to believe in, oh Lord, arise. My best friend died a lonely man, some Palm Springs hotel room. I got the call last Christmas Eve, they told me the news. I tried all night not to break down and cry as tears rolled down my face. I felt so cold and empty, like a lost soul out of place. And give me something to believe in.